Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and friends of North Harrison Baptist Church, or of Brother Lonnie on Facebook, or on Twitter at Pastor Lonnie Mattingly, on YouTube. And we're just glad that you've tuned in today for Mid-Morning Manna, coming to you from the auditorium here at North Harrison Baptist Church. We have a great time here. We've had a great week so far. And on this Wednesday, I want to invite you to come join with us for our Wednesday night service, our prayer meeting time. And Brother Shane Rogers, my co-pastor, is going to be preaching. He's our co-pastor here at the church. And we share the preaching responsibilities and other responsibilities. It's just going to be a great time. I hope you'll plan to come be with us and enjoy it. If you have a church where you already attend faithfully and regularly, then be in your place tonight and do the work you're supposed to do. But I believe in being in loyalty. I think that's a good thing too. This week, we're studying how to read your Bible. How to read your Bible. And we've talked about reading your Bible confidently or with confidence, how important that is. As I read the Bible, I know I have the Word of God. So I'm saying, have a Bible you believe in and then believe it. Read it. And I recommend the King James Version of the Bible. And then number two, we talked about not only reading the Bible confidently, but number two, read the Bible thoughtfully. Put some thought into it. Stop and meditate on what you read. Underline something. Jot down a note. Think on the things that God gave you as you read His Word. Whether you had time to sit down and read three or four chapters, or whether you only had time to read a half a page, whatever you could do, just ask God to help you to apply those things in your life. And then we're talking about today, reading the Bible consistently. Be consistent. A lot of people get off to a good start, especially back in January. They say, okay, one of my vows this year is I'm going to read the Bible through. I'm going to read an average of around three chapters a day. And in 365 days, I'll have read the Bible through. And they get off to a good start and they really hit it running. And they'll go one day in a row, or maybe 2 days in a row, or maybe a week, reading the Bible every day, and then all of a sudden they miss it. They say, well, I'll catch up tomorrow. I'll read double. I'll catch it up. Then tomorrow comes, and they start, and they only get halfway through one day and say, I've got so much to do today. I'll leave here, but I'll mark it. I'll be back. And then maybe two or three days later, they'll try to get back to it again, and then before long, they're just discouraged of not doing it at all. And I just think you need to read the Bible consistently. You need to have a daily relationship with the Word of God, a daily relationship where you're spending time in the Word of God daily. It will do so much for your spirit, for your attitude, for your faith in God. And what a blessing it will be. And God will give you some thoughts and ideas that you'll share with other people, and you could be a tremendous blessing and be used of God to be a help to somebody else. So I want to give you one verse today in Joshua chapter 1, verse 8. He said this, "This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success." So he's talking about as you read that Bible on a daily basis and meditate therein day and night, and he said that thou mayest observe to do. Don't just read it for information. Read it for motivation to do, carry out what God has been telling you as you read the book. As God gave you instruction in His Word, then you do those things that God told you. And by the way, let me also add this. You don't do those things God told you not to. Doesn't that make sense? We've got to quit this thing of thinking somehow I can justify, I have unusual circumstances, I have unusual needs, so it's okay if I go somewhere I shouldn't go, or if I eat or drink something I shouldn't have, or if I say some words that I shouldn't have said. That's just my temperament. That's just the way I am. Listen, quit making excuses and just do what God tells you to do. Don't do what God tells you not to do. And you say, where can I find all that? By spending time with God, reading the book on a daily basis. And sometimes read it in the morning and at night. Just let God use you. Well, we're going to have a great day. This is Wednesday, and this coming Sunday, we're going to be having a great day. Andrew, Russ, and the Thrins are going to be here. It's going to be like a Sunday morning and Sunday night. They'll be with us. It's going to be like an all-day concert. These people are unbelievably musical. They will bless your heart. If you've been hungry for some good singing, some good gospel singing, somebody with some spiritual energy to lift your spirits and help you, then you're going to love to hear Brother Andrew Russ and the Thrins as they come to sing for us, and it'll be a blessing to you. So I hope you will, and that'll be this coming Sunday and Sunday morning and Sunday night. We'll tell you more about it maybe by Friday, and we'll have a good time with that. But meanwhile, back on earth, let's spend time daily in the Word of God and read the Bible consistently. Don't be hit and miss. Get the Word of God in your life on a daily basis. Well, let's pray together, and we'll hear another song from Al Martinez. He's our singer of the week, and I thoroughly enjoy his music. He's a Filipino man, loves God, and is a powerful singer. You'll like him. Heavenly Father, I thank you for loving us the way you do. Thank you for the joy of serving you. Thank you, Lord, that you've given us your precious Word. Lord, we love this book, and we want to apply it in our lives. We want to be used of you. And we thank you for what you're doing. Thank you for, Lord, bless the folks that are watching in right now. Lord, some of them are going through some very heavy burdens and heartaches. Pray you'll bless them. Give them the encouragement they need. In Jesus' name, amen.
Happy faces line the hallways, those whose wives have been redeemed, the broken homes that he has mended, those from prison he set